Good morning, students. In our previous video, we discussed about different food items and the ingredients used for preparing them. Now, in our today's video, we'll discuss the topic food materials and sources. So, in this topic, we'll study about different food materials and the sources from where they are obtained. It may be easy for us to guess the sources of some of the ingredients that we listed in table 1.2. So we made a table 1.2 in the previous video. So we can commonly tell about some of the ingredients like oil, spices, salt. All these are some common ingredients for some dishes. Fruits and vegetables, for instance. Okay, for example, we can also consider fruits and vegetables. Like, see, if you want to prepare vegetable curry, for that vegetable is a common ingredient. If you are preparing fruit chaat, for that fruits are the common ingredients, isn't it or not, children? Where do they come from? So the question is that from where do we obtain these fruits and vegetables? Plants, of course. So all of us know that we obtain fruits and vegetables from plants. What are the sources of rice or wheat? Now the question is that from where do we obtain wheat and rice? So children, we know that rice and wheat are also obtained from paddy and wheat plants. You may have seen paddy or wheat fields with rows and rows of plants which give us these grains. So all of us have seen paddy fields and wheat fields. What does paddy mean, children? It means dhan in Hindi. So see, in figure A, you can see that these are some plant products. This also, isn't it? And then there are food items like milk, eggs and meat, which come from animals. Now see, these food items, that is milk, eggs and meat, these are what? These are animal products. These are obtained from animals. Animals are the sources of these food items. See, in this picture you can see that egg is an animal source. It is obtained from hen. Now let's do this activity, activity 3. Let us take the food items listed earlier and try to find out where they come from, the ingredients and their sources. Okay, so whatever food items we have discussed till now, let us discuss something about their ingredients or their sources, that means from where they are obtained. Some examples are shown in table 1.3. Fill in the blanks in table 1.3 and add more examples to this list. Now see, children, this table 1.3, ingredients used to prepare food items and their sources. In the first column, we have listed some food items. In the second column, their ingredients are mentioned. And in the third column, sources, that means from where they are obtained, is written. See, first dish is idli. So what are the ingredients of idli? That means what all things are needed for preparing idli? That is rice, urad dal, salt, water. Now here you have to mention their sources. See, rice is obtained from plant. Urad dal is also obtained from plant. Salt is obtained from seawater. Water is obtained from water body. Next is your chicken curry. For that, what do you need? Chicken, spices, oil or ghee, and water. So children, all of you know that chicken is an animal product. It is obtained from animal. Spices are obtained from plants. Oil and ghee are also plants and animal product, isn't it? Water, it is obtained from water bodies. The next dish is kheer. For that, what do you need, children? All of you have eaten kheer, isn't it? So for that, you need milk, rice and sugar. Milk is an animal product. Rice is a plant product, and sugar is obtained from, again, plant, that is from sugarcane plant. Right, children? Now see, what do we conclude from activity 3? So after doing activity 3, what did we come to know? Plants are the sources of food ingredients like grains, cereals, vegetables and fruits. Okay, so some ingredients like grains, cereals, vegetables and fruits, all these are obtained from plants. Okay, these are what? These are plant products. Animals provide us with milk, meat products and eggs. Okay, so we obtain milk, meat products and eggs from animals. That means these are animal products. Okay, children. Cows, goats and buffaloes are some common animals which give us milk. So all of us know that these are some common animals from whom milk is obtained. Milk and milk products like butter, cream, cheese and curd are used all over the world. Okay, so butter, cream, cheese and curd, all these are milk products and milk is obtained from animals. Okay, now see, can you name some other animals which give us milk, children? Yes, camel, yak, donkey, reindeer, etc. are the examples of some such animals which give us plant parts and animal products as food. Plants are one source of our food. Which parts of a plant? Okay, so we know that plants are one source of our food. In fact, we can say that plants are one of the most important source of our food. But which part of the plant? Let's read and find out. We eat mainly leafy vegetables. We eat fruits of some plants, sometimes roots, sometimes stems and even flowers. Okay, so not only fruit or root, but sometimes stems and flowers of a plant are also eaten by us. For example, onion, turnip, carrot, etc. These are root part of the plant. An example of some stem vegetables are asparagus, ginger, etc. What about flowers, students? Cauliflower, broccoli, etc. are some examples of flower part of a plant that can be eaten. Have you ever eaten pumpkin flowers dipped in rice paste and fried? Have you eaten, children? If not, then you can try it once. Some plants have two or more edible parts. So edible means eatable, that can be eaten by us. Okay. So not only one, but two or more parts of the plants can also be eaten. Maybe it is root part, fruit part, flower part, and maybe it can be the stem of a plant too. Seeds of mustard plants give us oil and the leaves are used as vegetables. Now see, for instance, we can consider mustard plants. Seeds of the mustard plants are used for obtaining oil and leaves can be used as green vegetable. So in this way, two parts of these plants are edible. Can you think of the different parts of a banana plant that are used as food? Yes, we can talk about this also. Banana, the fruit part is also eaten and its stem part is also eaten by us, right? Fruit, all of us know, we eat it. And what about stem? Stem of banana is high in fiber and it can aid in the treatment of ulcers. Okay, children? Think of more examples where two or more parts of single plant are used as food. So if you can think of some more plants whose not only any one particular but two or more than two parts are used as food. For example, we can say mustard plant, pumpkin plant and coriander plant. See, in mustard plant, its seeds as well as the leaves both are edible. In pumpkin plants also, its fruit, that is pumpkin, and the leaves are also edible. And what about coriander plant, children? Coriander plant also, we can eat its leaves as well as the seed part. Okay, so these are the examples of some plants whose two or more than two parts are edible. Now see the picture of this plant. All the plants are having basically two systems, that is root system and shoot system. The part of the plant which is below soil is called root system, and the part which is above soil is called shoot system. Now see children, roots are also divided into two categories, that is primary root and secondary root. Do you know children what is primary root? The first root of a plant originating in the embryo is called primary root. What is secondary root, children? Secondary root is a side branch of the main root. It is also called lateral root. You can see that this is the main root. So this is primary root, and these branches of the roots, these are called secondary root. Now comes shoot system. The part of the plant which is above the soil is called shoot system. Now see, here you can see node. What is node? Node is that area of a plant from which leaves and branches grow. You can see in the picture clearly, children. What is internode? The gapping between two nodes is called internode. See, one node is here, the other node is here, and the gapping between these two nodes is internode. Then is your bud. What is bud? A bud is a small pointed lump that appears on a tree or plant and develops into a leaf or flowers. You can see children, this small bud is here. It will further grow into a flower or into a leaf. Now this is leaf, stem, this is fruit of the plant, and these are the flowers. I hope this much is clear to all of you. Next is our table. Plant parts as food. First column is food item with plant as major sources. Second column is ingredients or the sources. Third is plant part which gives us the ingredient. So the first dish here is brinjal. Brinjal curry. What all things are needed for preparing brinjal curry, children? Brinjal, chili as a spice, or you can also take any other spice. Oil from groundnut, mustard, soybean, any other plant. Now see, brinjal is which part of the plant? It is fruit part of the plant. Chili, it is also again fruit part of the plant. And see, oil. Oil is obtained from groundnut, mustard or soybean. So what are these, children? These are the seeds. So this is seed part of the plant. Is it clear to all of you? I hope all of you have understood it. To activity 5. Take some dry seeds of moong or chana, put a small quantity of seeds in a container filled with water and leave these aside for a day. Okay, so you have to take some quantity of moong or chana and you have to put them in a container which is filled with water. Keep them aside for a day. Next day, drain the water completely and leave the seeds in the vessel. Okay, so next day, drain the water and let the seeds be in the container. Next, what you have to do is wrap them with a piece of wet cloth and set aside. Now these seeds, you can wrap them in a piece of wet cloth. The following day, do you observe any changes in the seeds? So this activity you can do at your home and find out. A small white structures may have grown out of the seeds. If so, the seeds have sprouted. In the children, can you see, children? This is the whole moong and this is the sprouted one. Okay. So When these small white structures come out of the any food grain, then that seed is called to be sprouted. Okay. If not, wash the seeds in water, drain the water and leave them aside for another day. Okay. If after one day the seeds are not sprouted, you can set them aside for another day. The next day, see if the seeds have sprouted, and next day again you will see whether the seeds have sprouted or not. Okay, here you can see the sprouted chana. After washing these sprouted seeds, you can eat them. Okay, so once the seeds are sprouted, you can eat them, and it is really healthy. Okay, children, they can also be boiled. Add some spices and get a tasty snack to eat. Okay, so it is very good and very healthy to eat sprouted seeds. Do you know where honey comes from or how it is produced, children? Let's read and find out. Okay, have you seen a beehive where so many bees keep buzzing about? Bees collect nectar from flowers, convert it into honey and store it in their hive. Okay, so bees, they collect the nectar. What is nectar, children? Sweet juice of flowers. Okay, so you must have seen bees, they often sit on the flower and collect nectar from it. Okay, and this nectar, they convert it into honey and store it in their hive. Flowers and their nectar may be available only for a part of the year. Okay, so children, obviously flowers, they cannot grow throughout the year, they are seasonal. Okay, so what bees are going to eat when there are no flowers? Okay, so they store their food in the form of honey. Okay, so that when there are no flowers, they can eat this honey and fill their stomach. So bees store this nectar for their use all through the year. When we find such a beehive, we collect the food stored by the bees as honey. Okay, so in these beehive, bees store nectar in the form of honey for themselves. Okay, so that they can consume it during those time of the year when there are no flowers. Okay. Now our next topic is, what do animals eat? Okay, children. So based on what animals eat, they are divided into three categories. That is herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. What are herbivorous animals, children? Plant-eating animals are called herbivorous animals, or the animals which eat plants as their food are called herbivorous animals. Second is carnivorous animals. What are carnivorous animals, children? These are the flesh-eating animals, okay? Or you can say that the animals which eat other animals as their food are called carnivorous animals. And the third one is your omnivorous. These are those animals which eat both plants as well as animals, okay? So in this category, those animals are counted which are herbivores as well as carnivores. That means they eat flesh also and they eat plants also. Okay, children? So with this, we have completed our first chapter. Thank you.